07, turn right, heading 185, reduce speed 182 or not.
185 on heading 180 on speed golf air 007.
Speed limit 124, reduce speed 160 or not to 40
a minute. Reduce 160 to 4, speed 124.
Hello there guys, Matt here, hope you're all well, and I was just about to edit this video and I realized I'd forgotten to do an intro, so my bad. It's now the following day since I recorded this, it's incredibly early and my voice sounds ridiculous. So I do apologize for that, but I don't have the time to wait until this afternoon, until my voice sounds mediocrely okay, so you'll just have to deal with it. Anyway, you've seen the Airbus a million times, and flying it on my own is not something I'm really doing anymore. However, there's always an interesting dynamic when you do the shared cockpit or connected flight deck if you want to be more PC, and that's exactly what I am doing in this video. I'm with Jacob. Jacob is a VATSIMmer like myself. He's a C1 over in the Copenhagen bit of the world. And some of you may know him if you watch my Twitch live streams as Shepred TV. Shepred being because he spelt shepherd wrong, so it's now Shepred. Anyway, we pretty much explained most of what we're doing in the video, but I thought I'd just preface the video with a bit of an intro just to save some confusion. We're on VATSIM, we're in real time, we're flying the Airbus, it's an EasyJet, it's an A320, we've got some new sounds, and we had full ATC. Enjoy! You okay there?
Yeah, I'm just typing. Let's see if they fixed it, if COM 2 actually works.
It may do.
See, 13422.
13422 is the ATIS, yeah, for Gatwick.
Nah.
Oh, hang on, no. It works, but the batteries are off. So, try now. No, my COM2 isn't, like, it's changing on vPilot.
Yeah, but
it's not
like
identing the frequency.
Yeah, it's like it only really likes.
Let me just try something, not click anything.
Okay.
It might be a case of doing this. Yeah, it is. Wow, that is low.
GG.
Wow, that is loud. The problem is you can't listen to COM2 and COM1 at the same time. So if you go back to VHF1, it changes it back to 128.3. Oh well, never mind. Okay, so we're ready. Let's go through everything.
Yeah, I'll just use COM1.
You should probably say hello, Jacob.
Hello.
We're off to Jacob's hometown of Copenhagen. Apparently, the weather is not too great up there. So,
well, it's not too bad. It's just a bit of snow. But
I've not even checked the meta for up there. One sec. Copenhagen meta. Let's have a look. No, it's fine. 250 at 12. Yeah, there's no reported snow or anything at the moment. There is light snow showers on the TAF, but that's at 1900 Zulu, so an
by
hour
the
from
time.
There. But yeah, actually, by the time we get there, fair enough. Yeah. Nice. Okay, so we're on VATSIM. No idea of what sort of ATC we'll get. At the moment, we've got Gatwick Tower, we've got London Control, and then, wait, which FIRs do we go through? We go through Amsterdam, and then Bremen,
and then Copenhagen.
So we might get some, we might not. But we're just going to be running through the checklists, or not really the checklists, the flows that are in the Aerosoft Airbus. So if you know any different, then don't blame me, blame the manual. It's the easiest thing to use for CRM, so we don't kind of cross hands and do things that we shouldn't be doing, which sounds incredibly weird, but there you go. Okay, so Jacob's already started doing this stuff. I've got to do the following. Check the lights are on, which are already on. Floodlights on. I'm going to turn the instrument lights on as well, the integral lighting, whatever it's called. There you go, is that synced up for you?
Yeah, that's right.
Nice. We're using new sound as well. What are they called? Blue Sky Star. They did the sounds for the Flight Factor 767. They also did the Jar Design A320 sounds. And now they've released them for the Airsoft Airbus. And just as I said, that Bremen radar came online, so there you go. But yeah, they sound pretty good so far. The ambient noise is pretty nice, and the switches. Yeah.
They're very nice.
I'm turning the range on the ND.
But that Bremen radar, he just logged off, but he only covers Berlin. He wouldn't be covering
What's
us.
What's EDGG? Is that Langen?
Yeah.
Oh, fair enough. Jacob's a C1, so I mean, he knows the airspace better than anyone. I'm just going to trust everything he says. And then he's probably going to get told off for being wrong, but there you go.
Probably.
Yeah. Anyway, battery's on and external power's on at the moment because we're lazy and we haven't started the APU. ADIRS is a good point. I need to turn those on to nav. Dude, those switches.
Very nice.
So cool. Okay.
Alright, I'm just going to check the ATIS quickly.
Sweet. This is going to be loud. Actually, it's not too bad. I'll just do my stuff while we're on the ATIS.
Bravo, and advise aircraft type on first contact. Kedwick information. Bravo, time 1720, runway news 08,
right.
Surface wind 060, 4 knots.
Right,
cavalcade, temperature plus 1, 2.92, change 1014. Acknowledge receipt of information. Cut.
Great. Dude, listen to those seat belts.
Wow.
Okay.
It really gets ruined by Aerosoft dodgy texturing there.
Yeah, well. It is what it is. Right, so we're going from Gatwick to Copenhagen, EKCH. Our alternate is, what is ESMS?
That's Melmut or Storp, I think it's called.
And how would I pronounce that if I'm not from that country?
Malmo.
Malmo, there we go. Call sign is easy. What are we? 363 Hotel.
Yep.
And cost index, I've no idea what they use. I'm just going to go with 30.
Yeah. Probably way too high, but whatever.
Who cares? 370 minus 67. We're both using ActiveSky next, so we'll get the same. And block fuel is 7 tons, which is a little bit more than we need, but I figured just in case, it's better to be safe than sorry, as I figured out the other night flying into Heathrow and all my engines stopped working and the bombing didn't hold. So there you go.
That sounds bad.
Did you not see that?
No.
So the Flight Factor 767 has this horrific bug, whereas if you do a full flight and then don't reset the aircraft and try and restart the engines for a turnaround, the EGT just spikes and you can't get rid of it. So instead of resetting it, because I'd spent like half an hour pre-planning it and setting everything up, I just took off with the EGT really high. I got all the way to Heathrow, and I was in the Bovington hole because of the event, and all of a sudden both engines just exploded. And I ended up gliding it from Bovington. I was at 120 in the Bovington hole. I ended up gliding it down to the Rutford to 9 left and somehow made it. Rolled off the runway with the, you know, the residual power.
Yeah.
Onto the stand and just parked up like nothing had happened. It's great. Anyway, 08 right, did you say?
Yeah, 08 right.
Okay. What were you saying?
Well, you still have that some of the time.
No, I disconnected. Screw that.
Yeah.
It was literally, dude, the delay in the bombing and hold was like 35 minutes, and they still had people, you know, the Lambourne 3 Alpha? You've got Sabre and then Brazo or Brasso, whatever it's called. They were holding a Brasso as well as Lambourne. So I just gave up. I was like, nah, it's not happening. I'm done. Anyway, Clacton outbound, UL620.
Right, I'm gonna go for clearance.
Okay.
Gatwick Tower, good evening. EC363 Hotel. Airbus A320 is stand number 2. Information Bravo on board. Press clearance to Copenhagen.
Station calling for clearance, say again, call sign.
EC363 Hotel.
EC363 Hotel, Gatwick Tower, good evening. Cleared to Kastrup, Clacton 1 Zulu departure, squawk 6244.
Cleared to Copenhagen, Clacton 1 Zulu departure, squawking 6244, EC363 Hotel.
Yeah, can I transmit, please? Three
hotel,
your readback was correct.
I don't know what to say.
Right, basically.
Yeah. Randomly just overtalk the controller on a readback. It's fantastic. Great. Anyway, the MCD is complete now, so it's all good.
Got 6244.
JD871,
push and start
approved, face west.
Okay, so let's grab that departure chart. It's 4-50.
Hang on, let me just get it up.
Condo 965, yeah, you are. I've already cleared you to taxi you onto 0A left, sir, so 0A left, Quebec and Kilo.
Let's see, Clacton 1 Sulu.
Yep.
Yep, got it.
Okay, so Clacton 1 Zulu, this is an RNAV departure. There's a few step climbs. However, the initial climb is 5,000 feet to be level at Detling, and then it climbs to 6,000 feet of Clacton. However, there's a 5,000 feet restriction initially. Airborne frequency is irrelevant because we're not in real life, so 120.525 is not where we're going, we're going to 123.9.
Yeah, rather.
But everything else is fine. There's nothing to back up because it's R now. So, yeah, life is good.
Easy peasy.
We're parked on stand 2. If you look at 3-20. Stand 2 is just next to taxiway Mike. So I would imagine that they're just going to push us back onto Mike and then. Wait, they're landing on. They're departing on 08 right, aren't they? Yeah.
Yeah.
They're departing 08 right. So they're going to push us onto Mike, and then they'll probably taxi us Mike, and then Zulu, Juliet, all the way down to 08 right. Which is going to take the best part of about 4 hours. You know, it's really good weird. This is deja vu from. This is when. Remember the Dash 8 video when everything went wrong? This is how it all started, doing like legit cockpit preparations. First of all, we saw an MD-11 just stall out the sky on climb out, and then from that point onwards, it just went wrong.
So. You mean every Dash 8 video?
Wow. Okay.
Well, I mean, it's the truth.
Alright. I'll test you in it next time. Do you have the Pro? You do, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
You should try that one day.
Yeah, I tried it with Christian once.
Nice.
You... Not nice.
Alright, I'm closing the doors for catering because they're done.
Yep.
I'm also going to request push and start. What's the temperature?
Temperature, I should know this since I just checked ATIS, but let's see. Temperature is 1.
Okay, we do need de-icing then. Yep. So we'll do that first. Get everything closed and ready to go. Right. I'm gonna start the APU. Close all the doors. I need to like do a crash course in the different types of de-ice fluid that they have.
Ah, I don't know.
It just gives you a list of like, do you want this, 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 and this? I'm like, yeah, I don't have any, it's fine.
Press that button.
To be honest, actually, I don't think we need the ice because it's a clear night.
It's only if you've been on stand while it's been snowing.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, fair enough. I'll just go for the really the rubbish type, the type 1.
Yeah, I mean, it is easy yet, so we'll take the cheapo one.
Well, they're not that bad. There are worse airlines out there, as witnessed over the last couple of days.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, the APU is available. Okay, so I am going to turn off the lights. Ooh, that's so nice.
That does look very nice.
I wish they had, you know what, actually, have you seen the FS Lab spotlights add-on?
Yeah.
That would be really cool in this scenario, to have like a storm-type light.
It would, but it's just one more thing to set up.
Yeah, I know.
It's no.
Apparently it's very easy though.
They all say that, don't they?
Yeah.
Right, I'm gonna disconnect the external power.
Okay. Parking brake set.
Oh, hang on. Is it on for you now?
It's on now, yeah.
It's off for me.
Right, okay. This is easy. So what we do, go to connected flight deck.
Okay.
Turn the connection off, which I'm going to do now.
Okay.
Right. Have you turned it off, yeah?
Yeah.
Right, now set your parking brake.
Okay.
And then reconnect now.
Okay.
Okay, right. Are you back in?
Uh-huh.
Parking brake set.
Yep.
So if I do something like change the MCP altitude to 5,000.
Yep.
See that?
Yep.
Perfect. So there you go. I'm not going to edit that out. That's a pro tip. If you're ever in the shared cockpit and something desyncs, just carry on doing what you're doing. Don't press anything. Disconnect, fix the problem, reconnect, and it syncs back up. We've had that a few times, actually.
Yeah, I think we have, haven't we?
Right, the ice
it's
is
Zurich, among other places.
Oh yeah, dude, what?
What?
The ice trucks have the EasyJet logo on the side of them.
As if EasyJet had de-icing themselves.
Well, they don't. That's the funny bit.
Yeah.
Someone just landed.
Oh, that's
what was that? Is that a 747? Yeah, it is, dude. It's a 747 just landed. In oh. Some weird color, Atlas Air. Oh, it's the Polar Ops guys.
Oh, nice.
There's a couple of people taxiing out as well. Why is there an Air China 737 at Gatwick?
Air China's everywhere, dude. It's taking over.
Are they done with the anti-ice or the de-ice? Okay, cool. Well, I'm ready for the pushback or the four start checklist.
Yep. Okay, before start checklist. Cockpit preparation
is completed.
Completed. Wheel chocks
are removed.
They're removed. Cabin signs
are on and auto now.
On and auto is checked. ADIS
are all set to nav. No lights.
Nav checked. Fuel quantity
is set 6,980 kilograms.
6,980 kilograms checked. Takeoff data
is set, and my side's on the takeoff page.
Set power reference.
Set 1014, indicating 210 feet.
1014, indicating 210 is checked.
And below the line.
Below the line, windows and doors.
Doors are closed and windows locked and closed on my side.
Locked and closed on my side. Beacon
is now on.
Beacon is on. Thrust levers
are idle.
Parking brake
is set.
Set. Before start check is complete.
Perfect. I'm going to push back.
Okay. Do you have all the doors closed?
Yep.
I still have the cargo and the cabin door open.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, in that case...
Same thing again?
Yeah. Let me just disconnect. Gone.
And I'm gone. Okay. Aircraft doors. Front left. And aft cargo.
Oh wait, the hell? That's opening them for me as well.
What?
Yeah, like my cabin left forward left's just open and cargo's open.
Try closing them.
Okay, closing front left.
That's... what? That just opened
closing
it?
Closing aft cargo.
What? And so, your connection is off, yeah?
Yeah, hang on. Connected flight deck. Off. Another switch just set connection to slave. Are they both...
They're both open now.
Right, close it now.
Close doors, front left.
That's just opened it for me. No way. And that's opened it for me as well. Let's see if clicking it at the same time does anything. So, they both close for you now.
Yeah.
I'm going to double click it and see what happens.
Just opened it for me. Departure check completed. Fly contact
inserted. Relief parking brake. Let's see.
Giant 184, you have run a runway to taxi left onto Quebec.
Right, what's the state of your doors now?
Closed.
All closed?
All closed.
Oh, hang on. I've got all closed apart from cargo. Right. What about now?
Cargo open. Off cargo even.
Okay, what about now?
Closed.
I want to see what the shift command is. Is it closed now or open?
Open.
Okay. What about now?
Open.
What about now?
Open.
Hang on. What about now?
Open.
Oh, dude, I figured this out. Okay, what about now?
Closing.
Yes, I've done it. Right, so if you use the shift commands and not the actual button, like the button presses, then it breaks it.
Yeah.
Okay. Did you get push and start?
Not yet.
Okay, cool.
We have to reconnect as well.
I've already done it. Just turn it back on.
Okay. All right, let's just do a quick check.
Okay, I'll move MCP to 6 and then back to 5.
Yep.
Okay, cool.
Okay, bye-bye. Alright, let's see if I can get to that. I'll push back in.
Standby, 6.6
for me. See, this is why we have apron.
Jump hit on that now.
AC 36 and 3 hotel for push and start.
Perfect.
It'd be 363 hotel, push and start is approved.
Push and start approved, DC 363 hotel.
Yep. Ready?
Yep.
You got the clock, parking brake released.
Clock's on.
Blocks at 1-2.
Yes.
Turn that nose wheel steering off at the moment.
Oh.
Is it moving for you?
My GSX is just crying at me a bit.
Yeah, but are we moving for you? Yeah.
Yeah, it's fine.
We can't start because of icing.
Let's see which terminal building it decides to push us back into.
I know, yeah. It's always the case when you're parked on awkward sand.
Yep.
They're probably just going to push us straight back.
Yeah. Or into this red thing to our left.
You know, I thought you said then into the Tourette's thing.
No. Into the red thing.
Oh, look, there's some aces.
What's happening?
I don't like this though, because it's going to push us in the wrong way.
Yeah.
I selected nose right, so I mean.
So,
and this is definitely not nose right.
So it's going to keep pushing until it can turn the nose to the right.
Maybe it'll do us like a 180 or something, I don't know.
We'll have to wait and see.
If it stops here, I'm actually uninstalling GSX. Like, this is the most useless. We would have been better just starting on stand.
Yep. Yeah, I think it's gonna stop.
Hang on.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's carrying on. Have faith.
Come on, GSX, you
Come
can
on,
do it.
You can do it.
Start turning.
What's bothering me is that easy behind us has just got push and start clearance. So
might want to abort.
Hang on, I want to see what it does. Where's it taking us?
It's stopping.
Oh wait, yeah, it's stopping.
Oh my god.
How is that nose right? Parking brake set. I'm so done.
Come on, episode crew, give it some competition.
What is that? Push and start approved, face the blast fence. No problem. Anyway,
right.
Starting engine 2. I'm hoping these sounds are nice.
Oh, yeah.
AV 363 Hotel, you have actually saved a lot of
Star valves open,
so
N2 rotation.
You're able to do a
180? Yeah, we'll be able to do a 180. We're just starting the engines now because of the weather, and we'll call when we're ready for taxi. EC 360 Hotel.
Yeah, we're
going to
turn off. Oil pressure's up. And start valves closed.
Yep, engine 2 stabilized.
Okay, it's running well.
Left is clear. Right is clear.
N1's on the rise.
trip.
Oh, hello.
Hello, PT. How's it going? Oh, that sounds amazing.
It's actually really nice.
Oh, wow. I'm forgetting to call this stuff out. Oil pressure's up.
Yep.
Start valve is closed.
Yep, engine one stable.
Perfecto. Okay, after start flows, we can do.
Alright.
Engine mode selects as normal. Leads off. Okay, we'll take just engine anti-ice.
Yep.
You ready for a flight control chat?
Yeah, I'm going to need some nose steering on. And I also need the flight control page. Okay, let me just trim. Whoa. Six up. Right, you ready?
Yep.
Okay, full left.
Full left.
Full right.
Full right.
Full up.
Full up.
And all the way down.
Full down.
Rudders into the left.
Rudder left.
And rudder right.
Rudder right.
Okay, after start checklist.
After start checklist. Anti-ice.
Is on. Engine. Is
engine on. Ecamm status.
Is checked.
Checked. Pitch and rudder trim.
Pitch 0.6, rudder 0.
0.6 and the 0 is checked. Hand signal
is received.
I'll take your word for it. After start check, this is complete. Well, I can't see him.
Taxi lights on. While you're calling for taxi, I'll just power up and spin it around here.
Yep. So. DC 36 and 3 hotel for taxi.
Sorry, station
Prong,
say again, call sign.
EC 363 Hotel.
EC
363
Hotel, go ahead.
EC 363 Hotel, requesting taxi.
Okay, EC 363 Hotel. Roger, in that case, taxi holding point Juliet 4 via Juliet, Mike, Alpha November.
Okay, holding point Juliet 4 via Juliet, Mike, and Alpha November. Okay. EC36.
I see what he's trying to do. So we're on Juliet at the moment, yeah? So first left's going to take us onto Mike, and first right's going to be Alpha November. Actually, no, second right's going to be Alpha November.
And then... Opposition.
Wait, what?
Opposition? 363 Hotel.
Yeah, that didn't make any sense.
865 to Romeo, taxi holding point Juliet 4 by Juliet.
I see what he's trying to do. He's trying to take us around it.
Juliet 4 by Juliet.
But I think this EasyJet in front of us blocking us, so he's going to take us behind him.
EC 363 Hotel, taxi holding point Juliet 4 by Juliet following your company A320 ahead.
Juliet 4 by Juliet following the company ahead. EC 363 Hotel.
Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, he was trying to take us like a U-bend around him.
Yeah.
But... Well, just landed then. They took up all the runway.
Jesus.
It's, what is that? Is that an Airbus A300? It is? It's an A300 passenger, not the cargo, the other one.
You know what? I actually saw an A300 in Budapest.
I've been on an A300 to Antalya with Honor Air about 8 years ago. And it was probably one of the smoothest flights I've ever had. But then they got banned from operating in the UK.
The one I saw, it was taxiing just past the passenger terminal.
Yeah.
It was unmarked, you know, like a standard blue and white colour.
Mm-hmm.
And I just pointed to it, and I said, I am so glad we're not going on that.
See that guy in short final?
Oh yeah. So we'll just make the left and then the right.
Yeah, it just kind of follows itself around. I'm just following that easy jet ahead of us. Yep. This guy on the left is stopped. Okay. Okay, so he's waiting for us.
Papa.
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 Can you repeat that blue for speed 1513?
Speedway 1513, Roger, after an
did he say,
ETA
which did he say? Juliet and
Juliet,
line.
Juliet 4.
Taxi stand 52 via Papa.
I can't take that seriously.
it's Matthew Wilson, that guy. He works for, you know, have you heard of St. John's Ambulance?
No.
It's like a voluntary ambulance service in the UK. They do a lot of charity events.
Okay.
Well, not really charity events, but like, you know, when you go to like big events and you see, not paramedics, but like first aiders. He works for those. I don't know if he works or if it's voluntary. Quite sure how it works, to be honest with you.
I have no idea.
I know a few people that do it. It's, apparently it's extremely rewarding. This is worse than Amsterdam's taxi.
Well, I mean, it's a bit boring, but it's not worse.
To be honest, Amsterdam's taxi in P3D is just me taxiing on water, so...
I hate flying into Amsterdam because of the scenery.
Taxi to Gate are doing in Amsterdam, aren't they?
Yeah, no, it's Fly Tampa.
Fly Tampa, sorry. And is that the Easy Company going already? It is, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. We're a bit slow today, man.
I'm taxiing at 23 across the ground.
Whatever.
There he goes. We don't even need the full length, that's the stupid part.
But it's the same guys that did Copenhagen.
Dude, can you see that T-cast as a guy at 2600 feet?
He's not gonna allow us to make that.
Well, there's a will, there's a way.
No.
Do you want it, like...
Let's bet on it.
7.5 miles he's at, right? If you call now fully ready...
Well, we don't. We have to do the circus.
Well, no, we'll do it as we're taxiing.
Easy 16 Bravo Uniform, taxi holding point Juliet 4 by Juliet.
Inside of 5 miles, I'll let one go. Easy.
Maybe.
Just call him fully ready.
EC 363 Hotel, wait ready. Fully ready.
Easy
65
Victor Romeo.
Come on!
Contact yes!
Come on. What were we clear? Did Juliet what?
4.
Okay.
Right. Do you want to do a check list?
It depends.
If he lets us go now, yes.
No, I just cleared somebody to land.
Behind a landing A350 offshore final.
Okay, fair enough.
Juliet 1, runners and wave runway 085 behind.
Behind the landing A350, line up runway 08 right, EC 363 Hotel.
Okay, we'll proceed to Juliet 1 then, and then we'll do the four takeoff checklist when you've done your flows.
Yep.
That would have been so cool if it, to be honest, I've never seen an A350 on that sim, so that'll be a... That'll be interesting. I'm looking forward to seeing this A350 land, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah,
I hope it's actually a model of an A350. I bet it's not, I bet it's a CRJ. It's a CRJ,
yeah,
I don't wanna look at it. Right, let's do the before takeoff checklist.
Okay, before takeoff checklist. Flight controls.
Checked.
Checked. Flight instruments.
Checked.
Take a briefing.
Confirmed.
VR V1, yes. Rotate, V2 and flex temps.
V1 144, VR 145, V2 146, flex temp 55.
144, 145, 146, flexing 55 is checked. ATC.
Is set.
Set, you can bello.
Take off no blue.
Take off no blue. You're okay. Below line.
Sure, I'm lining up.
Okay. Right, so it's clear. Cabin crew.
Advised.
Advised. TCAS.
T-A-R-A.
T-A-R-A, engine mode selector.
It's normal.
Normal, PAX 1 and 2.
Are on.
Are on. Okay.
And get the lights. The outside sounds really nice as well.
Yeah, let me check this actually. Ooh, hello. Yeah, I'm just gonna stay out here.
We'll get the lights first.
Oh. Aren't they up?
What, you need the strobes and the hand lights?
Oh, yeah. Hang on. Always so demanding.
Sorry.
Right, there you go.
Easy 363 Hotel, runway 08 right, clear takeoff, surface wind 070 degrees, 5 knots.
08 right, clear takeoff, EC 363 Hotel.
Okay, you ready?
Ready.
Take off.
Oh, that sounds nice. Try and just quickly go to the outside view.
Can't.
Fair enough.
Manflex 55, SRS, runway nav, auto thrust is blue.
How's that?
Sure.
100 knots. B1. Rotate. Positive climb.
Yep.
Gears up.
Okay, Delta Kester 150, that's not a proper flight plan, sir. I can get one if you're having problems.
Gears up, lights off.
Cheers. 1500 feet, climb part.
Climb power trip.
Go to climb. There you go. Nice.
Easy 363 Hotel, contact Gatwick Dictator 126.825. Have a nice flight.
Over to the Dictator on 126.825, Easy 363 Hotel. Bye bye.
So we just said that.
Okay.
Flaps up.
Speed check, flaps up. Should I call him?
Call him Gatwick Dictator.
Gatwick Dictator, good evening. EC 363 Hotel, passing 3000.
The
363
Hotel, good evening, Gatwick Direct. Squawk
ident,
flight level
130.
Ident 130.
Ident
130,
EC 363
Hotel.
Okay, I got the ident.
Okay.
So, well, actually, it's my autopilot, isn't it? So. 130 set, open climb.
30, open climb, check.
And all the pilots coming in.
Pilots, check.
Dude, that was amazing. I did not expect him to say that at all.
No, neither did I.
I'm going to take the constraints off now we've cleared the bullet, so... The TCAS just to the south of Detling. 23 in climbing, or 23 in descending, so... No problem, standard Q&H set, 1013.
1013 set, passing 6,500.
Okay, and the after takeoff checklist.
After takeoff checklist, landing gear
is up.
It's up. Flaps
retracted.
Retracted. Packs
are on.
Right below the line.
Yep.
Barrel reference
set passing 80 now.
It's standard and altitude check. After takeoff checklist complete.
Brilliant. Get rid of that anti-ice now, we really need it in the first place, to be honest.
Yeah. Oh, look
better
at that, too.
To be safe than sorry. Sorry?
Look at that, too.
100 and... Wait, why is it differing on both sides? I've got 102.6 on the left, and 101.8 on the right.
It's only a 3-knot crosswind, so it's not that bad, and it's almost straight on.
Interesting.
I'm going to write that off as Aerosoft being Aerosoft. passing 10,000.
No, that's what I said last night. Okay, you get to the lights off. Actually, you done? Brilliant. Yeah, I said that yesterday, but not yesterday, the day before, about the flight factor 767, until the engines burst into flames. And I was like, maybe I should reconsider that decision.
Well, I mean, it worked most of the time, so...
Yeah.
Whatever.
These clouds look pretty epic.
Yeah, they're rather nice. And there's not that many of them, so they get stays above.
Yeah, so we actually have FPS.
Yep.
Is he going to let us climb higher?
I hope yes.
Come on, man. Stop traffic. Wait, hang on. Is that TCAS above us? Yeah, it is. 21 and descending towards us.
Oh,
see if I can visual. Oh, yeah, he's there on the right seam, just above the clouds.
Oh, yeah, see his lights.
2:30-ish. Oh, 2 o'clock-ish.
Well, he's far off. Come on.
Yeah, I don't know what he's doing.
Have some balls. Only playing with aircraft.
See who it is on Batspy.
Yeah, I'll show
you. It is. Easy. Oh, no, it's not. What the hell? There's no one in the vicinity. Unless it's that guy.
Yeah, Objector, good evening. Easy,
on the Oh, no, it is. It's Speedbird 633 going into Heathrow. He's going over the top of us. He's 767-300. Oh, yeah, look at that. Look at that dude, he's gonna smash into us.
What?
Look, can you see him?
Yeah, I see him, he's gonna go just behind us.
Traffic, traffic.
Oh, there's, dude, did you hear the traffic noise?
Advisory, yeah.
Wow. It's okay.
Alright, he's behind us, it's fine. Sort of.
That's what happens when you climb outbounds when you're not supposed to.
Unicom 122.8, EC363 Hotel, and we got a traffic advisory there from traffic, approximately our level to our right. Not sure if you're aware of it.
Yeah, EC363 outbound,
yeah, it's far
that's just
why
I checked your point
level
120, and he was just defending
true
125.
No, he wasn't!
Alright, what's Unicom? EC 363.
Yeah, it's fine, no problem. He's just descending into you, it's no issue.
No big deal.
No big deal, just stay out of his way. It was actually just today when I was flying into Copenhagen, Florian was on Bremen, yeah? And me and this FedEx are paralleling each other just over kind of the north of the Amsterdam FIR. And I called him up and he's like, yeah, there's a problem, and I was like, okay, what's the problem? He goes, well, there's another company traffic just off to your right-hand side. I was like, right. He goes, so fly this heading. So I flew this heading. And then he goes, nah, that's not going to work. You're going to hit into each other, and then your CEO is going to be very pissed off over the frequency. So he spun me north and separated me that way. It was fantastic. But you know Florian, like, he's on permanent cocaine. Like, it's a given.
I had a thing with him, a couple of world flights ago,
yeah,
where I was flying all the time. I think it was the year before we all flew on the stream.
Yeah.
and at the end of it, he just told me on the frequency every time I talked to him, "Are you stalking me?" It's great.
Right, we have another TCAS, 2012 o'clock, heading towards Dagger. It's sorry, not 12 o'clock, 10 o'clock. Dagger's 12 o'clock.
I don't have anything.
It's trying to. If you zoom out a bit, you'll see it. It's Speedbird 822 going to Copenhagen.
Oh crap! No, I don't have anything on my team.
He's out of Heathrow at 18, climbing to. If he's going to, dude, he's going to 37 as well. Are you serious?
Well, blaming us online, the one we'll be needing, so it's fine.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's already going to be ripped by that point, so.
Well, it's on Unicom, so it doesn't count. Okay.
How can we avoid that guy?
By going to 390 and knowing errors.
There's no way we'll get to 390.
Well, I don't think there ever exists weight restrictions at the time.
Have you tried to climb higher than the ceiling?
No. You can climb up to 390 regardless of your weight, I think, but
really?
I'm not sure.
Are you sure?
I mean, I've tried it when PFPX gave me a cruise of 390 and I was a bit skeptical because I was very heavy.
Yeah.
But it just climbed straight off, so, okay, whatever. Or we could just level up refine. Take the easy way out.
Well, we'll see, because at the moment his climb performance in comparison to ours is terrible.
Yeah.
Because we're out climbing him at the moment. His routing is. Where's he going? He's going Dagger Clacton, then Artov Somba. His routing's different than ours, I think. Yeah. Unless we're going through Sombor. Yeah, no, we're going different way. Nice is fine. Oh. We're going over Redfern that way. He's going to turn left after Clacton and go left to Artov. And then Artov, he's turning left to Sombor, whereas we're going to Redfern. So. And then I see someone else on the other side of Dagger, over Clacton. That's a Ryanair at 240 descending into Stansted, so we'll outclimb his descent, which is fine.
That should be fine.
Yeah. Seeing if I can see that speedbird off the left-hand side. Just keep a good eye out for him. So I like flying at night because you can see the lights.
Yeah.
In the day, it's good luck. It's like a needle in a haystack.
It's like, I think, no. Oh, there he is. I crashed into him.
I just want to keep turning the ND to hear the clicks of the thing. Anyway, I'm going to release the packs.
Start selling our lottery tickets.
Yeah. And what do they do? What was that scam? The airlines used to come around and say, "We are collecting for this charity. Please give your last euros." And they were actually taking like 50% of it.
They said it was really awkward because they only sold the scratch cards, whatever they called it, on the home brand line.
Yeah.
And it was like €2 for one, but then you could get the deals they had made no sense whatsoever. You could get €2 for one, and for €10 you could get 7.
Yeah.
but then because it was a special fight apparently. They doubled up everything, so for €10 you could get 14, and for €1 it would make no sense. It's like, okay.
Just a way to extort money out of people.
Yeah.
Dude, they're gonna smash into each other. Oh no, they're not, they're a level apart. Just.
I see one of the TCAS.
Yeah, one's at 12 above us and one's at 15 below. Actually, no, they're two levels apart. Clearly can't do maths. Radar, good evening. Easy 363 Hotel through flight level 355, climbing 370 inbound Redfern.
Easy 363 Hotel, hello. For present position, proceed direct to Bartop.
Direct to Bartop, Easy 363 Hotel. Nice 276 mile direct. Sadly, my first officer has left me. He's gone to get himself some refreshments from the galley. And he will be back. It's just me, myself, and I. Currently overhead Amsterdam's FIR.
Director
Bartol. It's actually the start of the arrival into Copenhagen, I think. Or maybe it's the initial descent point, I can't remember. I think you have to be 310 over Bartov, but there you go, that was from yesterday. Cool. Thank you.
Clem, good evening. You see 363 Hotel, flight level 370.
UE 363 Hotel, Bay on the radar identified. Good evening. Report Mach
0.78, EC 363 Hotel.
And so the sequencing begins.
Indeed.
Oh, never mind, maybe not. I was expecting some like MLG spacing there. So oh, never mind, we don't need it.
Reduce speed Mach 0.5.
It's in front of us is speed at 822, that's why.
Oh, speed at 822, can you increase to Mach
0.5? Ah, that's why.
Here we go.
The speed at 822's got a ground of 455 and we're 458, so.
Mach 0.7,
it's not too bad.
Well, I mean, it is a speed boat, so you can assume you can speed up.
That was for us.
Oh! Maintaining Mach 0.78, EC 363. Dude, is this call sign like a real call sign, or was it just something you picked up?
No, it's real.
Okay, because it's 8.
Yeah. Mach decimal 78 is selected.
7-8 is checked.
UV 363 Hotel, B10 flight level 310.
310, EC 363 Hotel.
Okay. 310, and we'll do vertical speed.
UV 363 Hotel, contact Copenhagen 135 decimal 27, bye bye.
135 275, EC 363 Hotel, bye bye. Okay, maybe we should actually pay attention to
you.
Okay, vertical speed minus 1,000. Seatbelt signs are on.
Already?
Yeah, descending straight away. I don't trust it.
Increased rate of descent.
Out on the Ryanair flight, right? I could feel we started to descend. And we were coming from over Poland and then over Bornholm and then, you know, in between Denmark and Sweden, over that way, over the Öresund Bridge.
Yeah.
And the land, you know, the seatbelt sign didn't come on until we passed the Öresund Bridge.
Wow.
I was like, what?
Open again, good evening, speed about 822, descending platform.
That's the guy in front of us.
310, direct Kilo Oscar Romeo, speed Mach 0.78.
Okay, look. I'm going to throw this control off again, because I know him, but I'm flying under your name, so he's going to have no idea who I am.
Trolling your own country.
Yeah.
Of course, for the Jungle 1 Foxtrot, I'm thinking the rest of your starting to break up stability too. Yeah, it was, as you said, direct call such as 921 Fox Fox, descent flight level 80 to the level at Porsche.
If there was no checkout, he would just have given us a direct to the ILS, but...
Yeah.
Good night, good afternoon, EC 363 Hotel, passing flight level 350 for 310, good afternoon, Nick.
ILS approacher.
Yep.
Okay. Tudlow 1 Foxtrot. Is there any transition now?
No.
Okay, sweet.
Expect vectors from Corsa.
Okay, so let me pull up the ILS chart for 22 left.
Minimum's 210.
Look at that.
Course 218.
Can you give me some weather?
Yep.
Transition altitude is 5,000 feet.
Okay,
the wind. Whoops.
Temperature is 0 centigrade, dew point minus 1, surface wind 250 at 13, visibility is greater than 10 kilometers, there's no precipitation reported, and the QNX is 0.015.
0.015, and okay, so Barrow 210. Do you want to do config 3 or config 4?
Well, you want to vacate as soon as possible. So
okay, config 4 then. That's all set. Is 80 restriction anywhere, or is it just an open descent down there? Okay. In that case, we will keep it in VS until we hit that TD marker, and then I'll let it do it in descent mode.
And with this weight, if you really step on the brakes, you should be able to make it off of runway 30. That's the ideal thing to do.
Well, is that what they do in real life?
Sometimes, yes. If they, if you know, if
well, we'll, I'll tell you what, then we'll just use auto brake too.
Medium.
Yeah, sorry. Auto brake medium, yeah.
Right, so, you know, if the aircraft is relatively light and they have a strong headwind, they'll vacate off runway 30, otherwise just Bravo 5 or 4.
Yeah, well, Bravo 5 doesn't have a rapid, Bravo 4 does have rapid exit.
Yeah.
But we're never gonna need a rapid exit, so yeah, we'll plan for 30 vacation. Are they okay with that though? They're not gonna shout.
Yeah, no, it's fine, it's not an accident.
Alright, cool. And then where do we park?
Foxtrot stance.
So that's
gonna be Foxtrot 5 probably.
What pier is, what terminal is that?
The low cost terminal. It's off to the right of the Delta stance.
Looking at the chart, APC parking chart. Oh yeah, I see it over there. Wow.
Yeah.
It's actually a really quick taxi then.
Yeah.
Can you not vacate Victor?
That's gonna be a bit.
MREV max auto brake.
Yeah, just planned it. It's like, sorry, we dropped the gear on the runway.
Did he tell us to maintain the speed?
No, he didn't give any. Do you want to ask him?
Yeah, just tell him what we're given 878.
Copenhagen from EC363 Hotel. We were giving a speed restriction on Mark 0.78 from Bayman. Do you still want us to maintain Mark 0.78, or we're free to do as we wish?
EC363 Hotel, you are free to do as you wish. Oh, God,
it's very sweet of you, thank you. Free speed, EC36.
Wait, what did he say?
Only because of me.
The joys of flying with locals. Okay, well, there we go. That's pretty much the done deal.
Yep.
There's not much difference anyway.
No,
just
really.
I hate having it in the managed speed when it doesn't.
Yeah, because you just forget it.
Not managed speed. It is managed speed, isn't it? Yeah, it's called managed speed.
It's called managed. Okay, left turn heading 360 and reduce speed 250 knots or less, EC363 Hotel.
Are you sure that wasn't a left 360 loop?
It could be.
360.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was right.
Yeah, you're right. Okay, left 360 loop and reduce speed 250 knots or less, EC363 Hotel.
Okay, so 257.
Yep.
We'll do a loop.
Loop de loop.
Reciprocal 060.
After completion approach 119.8, EC363 Hotel, be safe.
Are we to complete the loop and go carry on to Corsa or?
Yeah. I wish they had just given us some speed restriction earlier.
What?
What?
Did you hear that?
Was the loop because we're too high, or?
I think it's because we're too close to the traffic.
Yeah, but surely you can give delaying back.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not quite sure why we were given this. It's not really standard, but whatever.
Just going round in circles.
Round, round we go. Yeah, what was the wind? It was 250, wasn't it?
Yeah, 250.
Wanted to land on runway 12, but not really a chance of that. I think you can just go direct to Corsa and then we'll swing back on there.
Yeah, I don't trust it for doing that just yet. Let me get on like a nice cut and then we'll do it.
Alright.
It's kind of turning the heading too much and it swings to the right.
Yeah.
There's that bridge down there.
It's yeah, the great bulb.
So 2-1. As far as 0-2 now. Okay. Direct. And then approach 19.8.
Yep, switching over.
Roger.
Approach Grafton, you see 363 Hotel passing flight number 135 in that course. After Corsa Director Biggie, expect ILS 22 left and information Charlie's aboard EC 363 Hotel.
Okay, let's do this. So after Corsa Direct Lab?
Biggie.
Spell that for me.
Alpha Bravo Echo Golf India.
Okay, Alpha Bravo Echo Golf India. Clear that.
Insert.
Is that all good for you?
Yep, it's fine. Okay, well, don't be slicing. So the examiner, he's just asked me if we're interested in doing a failure of some sort.
What sort of failure?
I'm gonna ask him.
He needs to remember we're in the aerosoft Everson.
He's asking if we're able for a go around followed by an emergency of choice.
I suppose so.
We could just do like I go around saying our gear isn't locked properly, and then we do a low pass for the tower to check, and then we land.
Okay, well, you've got comms on that, so I mean, sure.
Alright.
Okay. So it's sad it's that we're not in like the NG or something, because we can actually set that.
Yeah, but I mean, pretend is a
we'll
thing.
Just pretend that we go gear up and it's not going up.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, we could do locked failure, so that's easy to do.
Yeah. Right, so when we approach here, we'll drop the gear.
Yeah.
And then we'll pretend like we still have one red.
Yeah.
And then we go around.
Mm-hmm.
Easy 363 Hotel. No one.
Okay. right, so we go around.
Yeah.
And then we'll just come round for a quick low approach,
mm-hmm.
and then we'll land.
Okay. So,
because that way we practice go around,
mm-hmm.
low approach, and he's probably going to give us a left hand visual if you're for 2-2 left. So we're going to turn right onto 2-2 left.
Okay.
Then the go-around procedure for 2-2 left, if I'm not mistaken, is a right turn or a left turn.
It says 500 feet or DME 1 of Oscar X-ray Sierra, left turn heading 187, climb to 3,000 feet.
Okay, so he's gonna, so we're gonna turn left over the Ursa, you know.
Yeah, over the bridge. Yeah.
and then we're going to come in to the left, and he's gonna probably going to give us a left-hand visual for runway 22 left.
Okay.
So you're going to fly that, and then do a low approach over 22 left, and then come around, do the same thing again, and then land.
Okay, so for the sake of people watching this, this is not actually real. We don't have a failure, but the guy is training on the approach position. So we're going to fake a gear problem and do a go around, and then from there we'll just take it, whatever happens. It's all about getting the go around and getting the information across to him first, and then he'll decide what to do. It's fine for us to guess, but I guess he's got his own plan. So yeah, we'll do the go around, and then, but up until that point we'll just pretend like it's a normal approach. Are we going to do the go around as soon as we get the gear warning, or wait?
Let's just wait until like 2 DME or something.
Yeah, and then we'll just call it. Yeah.
Hotel.
4000 selected vertical speed 1300. Check if that speed is what he still wants us at.
Just confirm you still want us at 250 knots for EC363 Hotel.
EC36
Okay, QNH 1015
set, passing 8.4 now.
Hang on, just set 1015 set, passing 8.3 now.
Okay, we passed 10K, so don't forget the lights.
Lights coming on.
And the approach checklist.
Approach checklist coming up. A bit unprepared here. Okay, let's see. Okay, approach checklist. Approach briefing.
That's confirmed.
Confirmed ECAM status.
Checked.
Checked. Seatbelts.
On.
On. Bar reference.
Set 1015 passing 7.6 now.
1015 passing 7.5 now. Decision height.
Is set to barrow 210.
Barrow 210 set, and your motor selector?
Normal.
Normal is set, approach set is complete.
Okay.
Okay, so we have to be careful after B gear, we don't let the plane turn itself, because technically we're not clear to anything after B gear.
Well, if he doesn't say anything, we just carry on straight line.
Yeah.
It's not as if there's a published holdover at B gear.
No.
I don't think we've actually flown a leg without doing a go around yet.
No, I don't think we have.
What did he say about the speed, by the way?
He wanted us 250.
Oh, okay. I wasn't listening. He needs to think about slowing us down soon, though.
Yeah.
We don't have the exact ability to slow down on a dime piece.
Well, I mean, we do have a sharp right turn.
Yeah.
But still. It would be nice to get down to like 220 or 210. And if my sim would actually stop rendering blurries, we could see Copenhagen off to the right, but that's obviously not going to happen.
Welcome to the world of flight sim.
EC36 Hotel, descent
to
a
fleet
best,
EC3
as well.
What did you send last bit?
Expedite descent, 3000.
Okay, 3000, then we'll expedite EC36 Hotel.
Open descent!
Open descent, ish check.
3000 selected.
Do you want a bit of speed break?
Well, no, because we're at 250 knots, so it's not as if.
No, I guess it'll go down pretty quick. Yeah.
I was just following the descent profile. I don't know why he's so concerned about us getting down that fast. Because we're going to level now, like, probably 5 or 6 before a B.
Yeah. Oh, well, whatever.
I don't know.
It's going to be 5 at memory,
Yeah, so you see Sweda, Sierra Victor Delta.
And then you're in the 589.
Just off to our left on Mendy. That's where all the Swedish arrivals are coming from. So that's when normally they'd be vectored down behind us. I think he's got one arrival from up there. I'm not sure if he wants that before or after us.
Okay, well, managed heading at the moment. Sorry, no, not managed heading. The other one, the opposite of managed.
Unmanaged,
that thing. Out captured.
Sure.
Systems on. 9 miles to go. Glide is right on where we are.
Yeah.
Can we please slow down, darling?
Shank, be nice.
Shango, come again.
I suppose we shouldn't talk. The quicker we get there, the better.
No. But then anchoring the brakes on in that right turn is not going to be fun.
He's 165 uniform, go ahead. Descent to full pass speed, connect 1015.
That does read and again, it's 1015. It was very.
Going through that cloud then looked awesome.
Yeah, these clouds are really nice. You know, whenever something new releases flight sim, yeah, and you just don't know how you cope with it without it before it's released, it doesn't happen that often, but when it does happen, it's just,
Is he going to turn us?
Hope so.
EC363 Hotel,
turn
right
heading
130, number 2, and
approach 2 to left. Right, 130, number 2, EC363 Hotel.
You really need to slow down.
And any chance we can slow down for EC363 Hotel?
EC363 Hotel, go ahead, slow down.
Okay, speed tower, EC363 Hotel.
Perfect, manage speed. 130 is set.
About time. might want to set it to like unmanaged to 180 or something, just so we don't slow all the way down.
Well, it won't slow all the way down. It'll go to green dot speed because there's no flaps out.
Oh, alright.
That's the biggest misconception of the Airbus, is that when you're in approach mode and you're in managed speed, it'll go below the green dot. It'll only go as low as the safe flap speed.
GG.
See, there you go.
363 Hotel, turn right in 190, clear LS bridge, 2 to left, 3 points.
Okay, right, 190, clear LS 2 to left, call established, EC363 Hotel.
190 set, localizer.
Localizer check, 190 set.
Feels good. 3 tons, alright, for what we plan to do.
Yeah, good thing we loaded a lot more.
Yeah, Clyde's is coming online now.
Yep.
Lock start, okay, flat one.
Speed check, flat one. Ready for reflection. Okay, 1,002, taxi holds around the 2-2 right, just taxi away, Panama, Foxton, Alpha, cross runway 1-2.
Okay.
How about Foxtrot
and Alpha for the
right,
you know, 5, 8, 9,
ding the cabin.
Yep. Cabin crew, sit down.
I've said worse things.
yeah, I was
so much for the localizer. Look at that.
Yeah.
It's not even anywhere near it.
Yeah, it's coming on. Slowly. Slowly but steady. Wait, that's not how you say it. Slow and steady. I think. Whatever. I give up.
Okay, glide's green.
That's green.
Flap 2.
Speed check, flap 2.
589 at Wintar 250 present 13, that's from a TQ right, it's single.
Stick to your autopilot in, but that's just because I'm not brave. It's not going to make any difference, but whatever.
Yeah. Hopefully it's going to clear up below 2k so we can do a visual.
Okay, so this approach is left 3,000 feet, so as soon as we go around, we'll wait until we're 500 feet, then set heading 187 so I can follow it on the flight director.
Yep.
Okay, cool, get down.
Get up. Oh no, not all the gears coming down.
What
oh,
shall we do?
I'm
flat four. He has to confirm if we're established.
Yeah, we're fully established, 2 to left, is it 3-6 to 3 or so?
EG 36
feels all while. Wind 2 plus 0 3 7
3
knots, 1 8
2 2 left, clear to land. 2 2 left, clear to land, EG 36
3 at all. Okay. Do the flowers and then land in chest. EG 1 6 uniform, number 2 plus 0 left.
Me, EG 1
6 identified flank level 190.
Okay, my aircraft.
Your aircraft, landing checklist, cabin crew.
Advised.
Advised. Auto throttle.
Is speed.
Speed, ECAM memo.
Landing, no blue.
Landing, no blue. Landing checklist complete, and we are cleared.
Perfect. So nice, the scenery.
Yeah, it is really nice. Especially when you just break from the clouds and it just appears.
Okay, just under four to go.
Coach, very good evening, Evelyn 271.
I'll call on Wayne 2 for the go around.
To Berlin, Tiger.
See that guy rolling on 2T right now? He just put all of his lights on and just blinded the
1,000.
Flaps
2.
Speed check, flaps 2. Going around, EC 363 at all.
Climb out.
EC 363 at all, I'll run that, climb 3,000 feet. Continue running,
okay, continue running.
Oh no.
Climb 3,000 feet, EC 363 at all. Back to 218 now, bugger for you.
Okay, thanks. Told you, it never works out. Flaps 1.
Speed check, flaps 1.
Okay, take the other pilot, I'll do it myself, thanks.
EG 165
uniform,
so
running
190,
good luck. Okay, level 3. Level 3. EG 165 uniform, that's
Then
writing 190. Where's 190
if you want?
Oh well, that went fairly well.
And you 165 in front of 3 hours.
Okay, flaps up.
We check flaps up.
Yeah, we're headed over. 190 on the heading and clear spot from me to the left. If you want to start.
Okay.
You can
363 hotel, so I'm left heading 100.
Left heading 100, you see 363 Hotel. Reason for go around, we had a wrong indication on the front landing gear. We'll be requesting a low pass, runway 22 left.
Egypt 363 Hotel, left pass on yellow low pass. Now turn left heading 100.
What did you say first?
I said roger that low pass, left heading 100.
Okay, left heading 100, you see 360.
Traffic.
What?
Yeah, it's departing to your right. It's going to turn right in a second.
Okay, cool.
Again, 1472, identify. Turn right, direct data.
Direct the radar, turn 1472, and we are for descending that plan.
Okay. I'll resubmit the approach
Great,
data.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I don't need to. I'll just reconfirm it. So it's activated again.
Yep.
That's all we needed it to do.
Let's
see how far it was going to take us. I'll call him in a second, see if we can get him to take us below.
Fuel is not the issue, so...
If you want to do a visual, just stick to ILS. It's all up to you, you're fine. That's 040, 36, that's 3 hotel.
040,
so
check. The visibility is fine, so I don't mind doing a pass with the visual approach. It's fine.
Okay.
It all depends on what his plan is. So. I knew that go around when he would tell us to do something different. Though.
Yeah. Well, exactly.
We did it by the book, so that's fine. Yeah, I see the bridge just underneath us.
Yeah.
Nice. It's still a bit of cloud. So after the low pass, they're going to say the gear. We're going to pretend that they say that they see the gear. However, we still have the faulty light. Therefore, it's still a Mayday, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So after the low pass, then you call the Mayday.
Yeah.
Cool.
Standard 1472 approaching 577.
1472,
we're good on fuel though. Minimums is 1.8, so 700 kilos above that.
Do you have any traffic on the TCAS on the ILS?
No. Yeah, I do. No, wait, what? No, I don't. I thought it was. It's the CI. It's the center fix. No.
Okay.
There's the guy just touching now, but that's it.
All
right.
Every time I fly that airline, you can turn this now, as long as you've got traffic in the way.
I think he wants us to do the ILS. We didn't actually request the visual, but we should do that for the next.
Well, it's fine. It's just a low pass. As long as they can... Wouldn't it just be funny if he goes, sorry, confirming gear is not down?
Left heading 310.
360.
360, I see 360. 3 hotel. Hotel. I'm tired of saying 3.
360 or 0000.
Yeah. Yeah, it'd be like, nope, your gear's not down. Sorry.
It would be funny if we've got all this planned and he goes, yeah, it's not down. Sorry, I'm using ultimate traffic and the models don't show properly. We could just message someone on the ground and say, can you look at our plane and tell us if the gear's down?
Right.
They could they could put that over the frequency.
I think that's... I'm not sure if, you know, the average Ratsim pilot's going to have the confidence to do that. Come on, give us a turn. Left 310, EC 363 Hotel.
310 is set.
310 is checked.
Copeland approach, good evening, EC 799 Hotel, Foxtrot 5
LSD. I know that guy.
Stand, Foxtrot 5, Copenhagen, information Charlie aboard, crest departure clear.
I don't
recognize
the voice.
EC 799 Hotel, Foxtrot, standby.
Can
you hear 1472? Drop the
legal aspects of the Spinal Pump, Monday, Nikon, 1-2-1. 1-2-8, Scania 1472, and be direct with the checkout to me.
Scania 1472, thank you, and thank you for traffic.
We're going to ruin his checkout.
Well, it was Thingy that asked us, it was not as if we did it off our own back.
Yeah, true.
E46W inform, pressing 1-2 is approved.
He really needs to tell us.
Yep, otherwise we're gonna overshoot. Come on.
Anytime now?
Yeah, just waiting for it.
Got my hands together.
You can pretty sick of free hotel. Left. Heading 07.
What? 070?
Yep.
Confirm left heading 070 for ET 363 Hotel.
ET 363 Hotel, my bad. Left heading
250. Left 250, thank you. We'll call established 22 left ET 363.
You know what he's done? He's grabbed the the Euroscope, the ruler in Euroscope, he's grabbed it to 2.5 and read the wrong side.
Yeah, he did.
He did the reciprocal. Okay, yeah. Localizes on the 250 set.
Okay.
That was quite funny. Okay, flat one.
Speed check flat one. Okay, so we'll just go into full landing configuration and then just not land.
Pretty much just do a low pass.
Yeah.
I mean, you can do flat two without the gear. Approach mode's on. On flat two.
Speed check, flat two.
EC 79 Hotel Foxtrot. I have my parking ready. Are you ready to copy? Ready to copy 79 Hotel Fox. EC 79 Hotel Foxtrot. Cleared to destination as well.
The glide is alive.
Glide's alive.
Oh,
look, the speed is bleeding off.
Okay, we'll check information Delta, but it's clear to surrender Gatwick Lango, 1 Charlie departure, 2 to right, we'll score 7310, easy 79 Hotel Fox.
EC 79 Hotel Fox, Delta, we beg to correct. I'll report, we're ready for push or start.
We are fully ready for push and start, easy 79 Hotel Fox.
$2,500.
Yeah, we're fully established, 2-2 left. We'll be requesting a visual inspection of our gear during the low pass. You see 363 Hotel, and provided that it is down, we'd like to request a left-hand visual for 2-2 left. If not, we'll look on further actions from that EC 363 Hotel. I set my call sign two times then, didn't I?
Yeah, it's okay though. You got the point, Chris.
363 Hotel, roger that. Please call Low Park on 22 from the inspection, I can't be really that much help since I am 400 kilometers away from the airport.
Ask someone on the ground.
You have to visual inspect yourself.
We'll ask a random pedestrian. Open the window and see 363 Hotel. Damn it.
Good afternoon, Scandinavian 472, gate Bravo 6, we're request clearance to Gardermoen Oslo.
Okay, so we're cleared?
Yeah.
Let me know when you want to gear.
316, how long until you're ready for taxi?
Okay, get down.
Get down.
Oh no!
Oh no, it's not working! What shall we do?
Flat 4.
Speed check, flat 4.
Hello, everyone. Make the approach.
Okay, landing checklist, are you ready?
Yep.
Cabin crew, let's say they've been advised.
Yep.
Auto throttle.
Speed.
Speed, you can memo.
Is landing no blue?
Landing no blue, landing check is complete.
1000.
Okay, so we'll just follow the standard missed approach again.
If you look out your window, it's possible for
you
to
book?
Hang on, be quiet, be quiet.
To push next to the door.
Oh, I thought you was gonna ask him to look for us.
No. Do you want to book it for you?
When we go around, not yet.
Just confirm, would you like us to push to the west or the east, EC79 Hotel Foxtrot? We'll just give it a check. EC79 Hotel Foxtrot, what else makes it easy for you?
I'll take it down to minimums and then I'll level it at minimums.
Vino 316, I have been hitting you. Taxi 2, full short runway 221.
500.
The scenery. So good. So good.
400.
300.
100
above.
Okay.
50 feet. 200.
Okay, leveling now.
Minimum.
Copy 1015, and we'll just wait for the weather to taxi and push the startup approved to face west easy.
Just float it all the way down there, the runway, and then we'll go from there.
Mm-hmm.
100.
Schedule 472.
Okay, this looks so awesome for people on the ground.
Yeah. Hi! Yeah, we've floated it. Bit long landing.
Yeah, 472, could you boost a bit?
Okay.
472, of course.
Go to
Garland, all as far as the other thing,
187
is set for you. Information Delta is correct.
Yeah, let's ask you, Ustler, how do we have one side of the departure, runway 221,
right,
and we
right.
Have squawk 7T15 in a box.
7472,
we've got
this
correct.
Hold box.
Okay, flap 2.
Speech
out, flap 2. Flap 2, departure, Lindu,
1 echo,
9 up
weight, right. Climb out.
And then
I
generate
right.
You knocked
it
into it. Yeah,
hang
on,
hang
on. The
pilot's coming in. Flap 1.
Speed check, flap 1. 0 at kilowatts.
I think I'm running into a VAS problem.
Okay, flaps up.
Speed check, flaps up.
Box 663,
coming
the bridge,
good
evening,
I think. You're running into a VASP problem. That's never fun.
Leaf Corsair, Oscar Romeo. direct, I believe.
Okay, now we call them Mayday.
Yep.
Mayday, 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 EC 363 Hotel. The gear did not lock. We're requesting a left-hand visual for 22 left as soon as possible.
EC 363 Hotel, left-hand visual for 22 left is approved. Report field in sight.
Left-hand visual, 22 left approved. We'll report field in sight. AEC 363 Hotel. Okay, so you can go down as slow as you'd like until you've got the field in sight, and then take out the autopilot whenever you can.
Okay, 770 set transponder.
Yep, 770 coming up.
I've already done it, but yeah.
Oh. It wants to
put on okay. You should get on the phone to the cabin crew and let them know.
Hi guys, slight problem, we're gonna die.
Hi guys, no gear, rip. We should just land in the water. It's much smoother. So now we've called a Mayday, doesn't that sterilise the runway?
Cargo 163 approaching Corso, say again, depart to
2500.
Okay, flap one, please.
We check flap one.
We're on the approach, although it's not going to make any difference.
Echo Beatty, Alpha Bravo, Echo Delta Alpha.
Right, I'm going to cut us in a little bit more, so about 020 should be okay.
You want to get down to 1000, so you're above, below the cloud even.
Yeah, for now, though, we'll just turn it and then we'll think about descending in just a second.
Alright.
Okay, sir, direct to Biggie, many thanks.
Can I report this 7-2 if the person's back?
Let's see.
8472, of course, started through. 2-1015.
Okay, 1500 feet set. Flap 2.
Let's switch out flap 2. Okay, I've got the field, do you have it?
Identify
Should be. You should see runway 30 just off to your left.
Can we not get 30?
I can ask.
No, hang on, let me just see. I can't see it.
We decide ourselves.
Dude, if we can get 30, that would be perfect. We can land on that right now.
Let's go 30 then. Let's go max auto brake then.
Okay. No, no, you don't need to do max. Okay, gear down.
Okay, gear down. EC 363 Hotel, we've got the field in sight. Is runway 30 available? Well, it is.
Of course
it is. EC 363 Hotel, runway 30 is available.
Flaps 4.
Speed check, flap 4.
30
clear to land, EC 363 Hotel.
Perfect. Okay, just set 3000 MCP just in case it all goes wrong.
Yep, 3000 coming up.
And the landing checklist, I'm going to take the flight directors out. Whoops.
Landing checklist. Now they've been advised, cabin crew, auto throttle.
The speed.
Speed, ECAM memo.
Is landing no blue.
Landing no blue, landing checklist complete, we've been cleared.
Okay, cool. It's a little bit below the glide, but it's fine.
Landing 271 Echo, please confirm direct.
Okay, taking the auto throttle out.
Out?
What the hell? Go out. There you go. Did you see that?
I did.
Go out.
Slightly below ground.
Yeah, I'm fine. I literally have no power. This is bad. Okay, there we go. We're good.
Before we actually crash.
Yeah, this is like, we tried to be clever and help this guy, and we've actually ended up screwing ourselves over.
Yep.
I'm getting nailed by some sort of wind. There we go. Now we're stable.
EC79
Hotel Fox, request taxi with the ice on the pad, taxi wavy. 400. Stop calling speed at me, the speed's fine. Okay, no it's not.
300.
EC79 Hotel Fox,
oh no, it's floating!
Shit!
No!
Get down!
It's okay, I got this.
200.
It's going to be max reverse though.
Just confirm from EZ79 Hotel Fox Dot, we're requesting de-icing operations.
100.
Bravo, taxiway Bravo, please.
70, 60, 50, 40, 30, 20, retard, 5.
Greaser,
nice.
Yay, the
gear
worked!
Way,
we're not dead! Hallelujah! Where's the runway?
Make your next right.
Mike, so don't have a touch with that holding MFG-0 Canada M472.
Okay.
I just confirmed that runway 22 right is departure, not 30. And M472 22 right is for departure. I just need to hold short at 30. Yeah, good. Then it's all short of the taxi of runway 30 Canada M472.
Okay, located Delta.
Yep. It's just all there.
EC36,
we've
got power,
or welcome
to your
meeting.
Is it possible
for
you to taxi stand, or do you
require
some time on
taxiway? Basically, the gear decided to work, so yeah, we can taxi stand
EC36 Hotel. EC36 Hotel, I'll write you that. Taxi to stand Fox Trot 5, using taxiway Delta Yankee. Correction. Full short taxiway Romeo Bravo, your taxiway Delta and Yankee.
Okay, so hold short taxiway Romeo Bravo via Delta and Yankee.
Okay. So this is Yankee's the second right. There's an outbound EasyJet Airbus. See
that's
that just there?
Short of.
Yeah, we'll just hold short of Romeo Bravo. Okay. Oh, my chart doesn't say Romeo Bravo, it just says Romeo.
Yeah, that's it's called Romeo.
Okay.
It's just because it links up to Bravo, and that's why it changes. So just make a right turn. Yeah.
Turn the AP on now.
AP is coming on.
That's
level
190. Hi, EasyJet. Look at that spinning stop sign over there to the left at the prop stance. Can you see it over the lights?
Oh, let me check.
It's my scenery then.
Whereabouts?
So just off to the left, at you know all the cluttered small stands.
Free hotel. Continue taxi to Fox.1. Using taxiway Romeo and Whiskey.
Fox.1 via Romeo and Whiskey. EC36 Hotel. Okay, so first left and then second right.
Yeah, I see.
Okay, Whiskey 179 Echo.
No, just Whiskey, and the stand is Fox.1.
Yeah, but it says Whiskey 1 on the chart.
One acre or so,
oh, whatever. I haven't controlled in ages. I think my flights have just crashed. Yep, fatal error occurred.
Nice.
Good.
Sorry, mine didn't.
Alright. Well, that was interesting.
I've still got to park up, yeah. What did they send us to Foxtrot 5?
Foxtrot 1.
Oh,
first,
yeah. I've already set it on GSX, and I'm actually... Yeah. I'm still assuming I got it wrong, even though I set it on GSX. It's pretty funny. Oh, I just blinded the marshal, that poor guy.
How did I run out of memory?
Because you don't have the Elite 64-bit version of P3D that I have. I'm joking. No, I actually have.
Okay. Mind sharing?
I'm going to park like a champion. Oh, minus 1, 0.1, that'll do. Parking brake set. Oh, you left the strobes on? Why are you so bad?
Because my P3D crashed!
Yeah, but we vacated the runway well before it crashed.
I wasn't paying attention.
Well, there we have it. Sadly, Jacob's computer didn't make it till the end, but there we go. I'm glad mine did, otherwise we wouldn't have had much of a video. Something a little bit different for ATC, two go arounds, a fake emergency, and then probably one of the worst approaches I've flown on my channel. But there you go. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, let me know. Again, the length is something of a little bit of a concern for me. I was thinking about cutting it into two parts, but I don't know. You kind of lose focus if you watch things like this in two parts. However, as always, your comments, constructive, would be appreciated in the comments section. And until the next video, I bid you all farewell. Bye-bye.